killed the suitor of our pain and not as our master. We know him as the repairer of the breaches, the one that opened closed doors, but not as master. Not as our master. Even if you won't heal me, you won't bless me, be my master. Even if things don't get better, when you call him master, it speaks of loyalty to him despite your unfavorable situation. When you call him master, it speaks of absolute and total surrender. Master. 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 Holy man Saprahadesh, master. When you call him master, number one, you put him first in all you do. When you call him master, number one, you put him first in all you do. I'll give you 4 points and I'll move on. If he's your master, then he must be first. He must be priority. He must be priority. Matthew 6:33, popular verse of scripture, seek ye first the kingdom of God. He must be first. If you call him master, you obey him even when it's not convenient. 1 John 5 verse 3 says his commandments are not grievous, even when it's not convenient. When you see him as your master, you daily understand that whatever you are is by his grace. Whatever you are, 1 Corinthians 15 verse 10, Paul said, I am what I am by the grace of God. These are simple truths that when you continually tell yourself every day, it keeps you in check to the lordship of Christ. I am what I am. I am what I am. When I see honor, extreme honor around the world, it puts me in check. It makes me scared. I am what I am by the grace of God. In this kingdom where we operate, in this covenant under which we are covered, the higher he lifts you, the more humble you become. The more he exalts you, the more you hide yourself. The more he advertises you, the more you hide behind the cross. Master, you constantly remember, if not for you, is if it had not been the Lord on our side, where would we have been? If it has not been the Lord on our side, say, not many mighty are called, because mighty are proud. Not many mighty are called, for he has chosen the foolish things of this world to confound the wise. For out of the mouth of babes and sucklings thou art ordained praise, that thou might steal the avenger. So God picks nothing, the foolish things on this world, that he might confound the wise. God does not tell me. So anytime you think you have seen a lifting, don't think you are you are anything of yourself. You are just one foolish thing that he has chosen to confound the wise. Anytime you see yourself giving him praise, giving him worship that is accepted, don't see yourself as so talented. You are just one babe and suckling that he has chosen through the mouth to ordain praise. Master, I am what I am. By your grace, it's you, it's you, it's you. Every honor is you. Every respect and accolade is you. Child of God, in that office, you didn't open that business because you have expertise. There are people more knowledgeable than you are, but they are stranded. There are people who have got connections, but they are nowhere. There are people who are anointed, but they are nowhere. It's you. Oh Lord, it's you. It's you. So every day of your life, never arrogate honor to yourself. Never come to that point in your life where you think you are anything. When you think you are anything, you say, I am what I am by the grace of God. With all the height Paul get to, God had to send an infirmity to buffet him. He said, yet lest I be exalted by the abundance of revelation, he has sent an angel to buffet me. And when I cried to him three times, I besought the Lord for healing. He said, relax, my grace is sufficient for you. You see, in the ark of the tabernacle, there are three layers. There is the holy, there is the holy place, there is the holy of holies, and there's the holiest of all. There's the outer court, inner court, and the